Christianity, but I didn't have the music. I didn't have the music. And see, it's interesting. When a person's saved, without exception, he puts a new song in your heart. Many shall see it and fear and trust in the Lord. Where there's an absence of song, friend, there's an absence of the sun. If there's no song in the heart, there's no sun in the soul, the Son of God. I ran across this illustration, true story, of a girl by the name of Jenny Lynn. Never heard of her before. She was a Swedish Christian singer. She quit her musical career at the height of it. As she was sitting by a lake one day, she was asked, "Why did you do this?" Listen to what she said. She replied, "When I thought nothing of that," pointing to the sunset. She's sitting by the lake, pointing to the sunset, and she said, "When I thought nothing of that and very little of this," pointing to her Bible, "then it was time to quit." That's good. Some of you, you're so consumed in doing and going and accumulating wealth, you're missing this. The wonder of worship. And it's going to cost you. It will cost you. She also said this, "Oh God, defend me from the task of dropping buckets into empty wells and growing old, drawing nothing up." Here's the second thing to help you in worship. Understand that your catalyst, that's the thing that strengthens everything else, your catalyst for strength to resist temptation comes from worship again. Remember, it's love for Christ. It's love for Christ. You say, "Well, how does that work?" Once again, remember that Christianity is always passive tense. You say, "Now, what do you mean by that?" It means that I'm not doing the acting, I'm being acted upon. So therefore, am I supposed to sit back and do nothing, just be indifferent and passive? Absolutely not, friend. But I'm to obey the Scripture, and then I'm to trust God to use that in my life to act upon me to create greater passion to please Him. Now, understand that as you're being acted upon because you're seeking God, as we learned in Sunday school this morning, we're pursuing God. God comes and He gives us future grace, which is the desire to will and to do of His good pleasure, that we might more passionately love the Lord Jesus Christ. And guess what? I overcome sin in my life. Once again, how do we overcome it? By love for Christ. I repeat, blessed is the man that will resist temptation, for when he is tried by the adversary, tempted by the adversary, he overcomes and he wins the crown of life that God has promised to them that love Jesus. So how do I increase in my love for Christ? By saturating myself in this book and determining to do whatever God tells me to do. And as I do that, guess what? Faith will grow and subsequently my love for Christ. The third thing, and we'll complete the message with this. The greatest thing you can do for your circle of family and friends is to be caught up in the wonder of worship. To be caught up in the wonder of worship. The worst thing you can do for your family and your friends is to be consumed with self-love and self-worship. Listen to the words of Oswald Chambers. Listen to what he said. Worship is the great essential to fitness. If you've not been worshiping when you get into the work, you will not only be useless, but a tremendous hindrance to other people around you. The greatest thing I can do for you as the congregation that God has allowed me to shepherd at this time is to love Jesus Christ. The greatest thing you can do for your marriage, for your family, your friends around you is to be caught up, consumed in the wonder of worshiping Him, which is loving Jesus with all your heart, mind, soul, and strength. That's worship. So, let's practice it. Can we do this? Let's all bow our heads together in prayer.